Dillard Baseball's inaugural season. You see 22 wins and a GCAC championship. Coach, tell me what these past few weeks, maybe even the past month or so, has been like for you and your program.
Past 2 weeks have been very busy, especially going into the tournament, and then after the tournament, after winning it, it was amazing. It's been fun. They've enjoyed themselves, and at the same time, I've enjoyed getting the university publicity. I mean, it's a great thing to have a brand new program, but to put the icing on the cake, brand new program, first year program in history, and then also winning the GCAC championship in that first year, it makes it so much better, so much sweeter. I would say the last month, it was kind of pretty good for us. We were at one point in time, we were all tied for first place in conference. I mean, not a lot of people thought we were going to be there, especially when you, like me, you just talked about with that dropping 14 games in a row. Not a lot of people thought that it was going to eventually happen for us. But the great thing about it is we had a good turning point, and we kind of saw some different things out of the guys. And, you know, you just keep repeating the same thing over and over. And eventually that drills in their head, and it becomes consistent to them. So now it's all, they're sleeping that each and every day. They're eating those words that you pouring out positivity. So it's been a great thing for us.
Off the field, what are some of the perks that you might experience being a young program that finds championship success in year one?
Off the field, most of the thing we did was just really tour the city, make sure we were involved in different things like that. I guess you would say me having that experience coming from Southern, winning that championship in 2021. And like I kept telling them, I would always bring my ring. They would always come and view it and different things like that. And I just told them, man, now I get to take that ring home. And now I'll have that new ring for those new guys that come in and different things like that. So not a lot, just off the field perks. But at the same time, you know, being able to go over to Wesley Barrows and playing at all turf stadium is awesome for us. Shout out to those MLB for allowing us to get access to the youth academy, and then also play our games there, because we weren't supposed to play our games there at all, because that's Xavier's home field. So they kind of worked some things around for us and allowed us to play there. So it worked out for the best.
From a recruiting standpoint, to find this success, how much of a sales pitch can this be for you moving forward, not just next year, but maybe the next few years?
I don't have to work as hard. I can definitely tell you that. You know, when you really think about it, how many teams in the country can say they won their conference championship? And think about how many teams are in each conference, whether it goes where you go from Division I all the way down to NAIA or junior college, you know, with the California Junior College and all those different teams. I mean, we're talking about over 1,000 universities, but probably only 100 of them can say, or if 100 can say that they're their conference champion. So, and how many of them can say that they're the conference champions in that first year? So we definitely made history there, and then we're trying to continue that success. Like I keep telling the guys, have you guys ever been to Idaho? I've never been to Idaho. Only thing I know about Idaho is potatoes, so let's go experience it. So we're looking at going into the regional and trying to get hot again, and at the same time, get to the championship game and let it take care of itself. Win a championship, we get to a World Series. Now we just created history all over again. So now we'll be having another conversation, and then it'll be much better.
I think the craziest part about this whole story is the fact that you guys started 3-21. You had that 14-game losing streak, and you end the season 19-7. I mean, what do you credit to a turnaround like that?
Their resilience, their focus, their just real, that mental toughness, that physical toughness as well, for them to understand, hey, there's still a lot of baseball to be played, and then we haven't even hit conference. Like I told them in the beginning, man, we were going to play against some tough teams. I mean, Mobile being ranked top 25, Loyola, Crosstown Neighbors, but being ranked top 25, William Carey, who's now top 10 in the nation, playing against Division I schools like Pine Bluff, UNO, and also Southern. You know, we don't – I can tell you this. As a coach, I don't shy away from competition. At the end of the day, it's the game of baseball, and anybody can be beat at any point in time.
So the season's not over today. You guys found out it continues in the postseason, the NAIA National Tournament. Coach, what do you want your team to take away from this experience as a whole?
For sure, enjoy this moment. But after, like I always tell them, two hours after now, it's all over with. We got to get back into it. We got to prepare because now we'll know our opponent. We'll know all the teams that will be at our region and different things like that. But we got to go in with a lot of confidence, understanding that we can win and we can get it done. No matter what conference, yeah, our conference is not one of the top ranked conferences in the NAIA, but at the end of the day, we get to play baseball. This is not football or basketball. And we got to be tough. We got to be resilient. And then again, we made history one time before. We had our backs against the wall one time before, losing in a tournament and then having to win three straight games and beat a team that was very hot in the tournament, beating them twice. Why can't we do it again? Who says we can't do it again? So let's make that history and let's continue this tradition and making history and winning championships.